Welcome to our first technical online seminar for hot melt adhesives by Vonik about foaming technology with amorphous polyalpha olefins. My name is Katharina Rawat. I'm chemical engineer working in the Vestoplast Applied Technology Department, and I organize projects for new developments and give technical support to our customers. Within the next 15 minutes, I will provide you with a comprehensive overview on our polymers, for hot melt adhesive applications, as well as the foaming technology, its basic principles and benefits with a few selected application examples. The foaming technology is not new for the adhesive industry, as it is used for several years in different applications to create foamed adhesives with special properties. We with Evonik know that particularly Vestoplast offers a wide process window for foaming applications. And in times of rising awareness of resource efficiency, sustainability, and continuous increasing cost and quality pressure, we focus on this topic also for new application areas. We have investigated changes in adhesive properties and significant impact of the polymer backbone to the foaming behavior and the influences of additives. First of all, we will introduce the foaming process in general. There are different foaming devices in the market, which allow to foam the material in a physical way. The hot melt formulation is heated up to the melting temperature, usually between 130 and 180 degrees Celsius. Nitrogen or air is added step by step under high pressure, for example by pumping the adhesive in a closed loop, while mixing the adhesive with the gas. The gas solves in the adhesive polymer like CO2 in a water bottle. Only as it is released at the tip of the applicator, the pressure decreases instantly. Hence the gas in the hot melt can expand and a smooth foam structure is created. To reduce the complexity of the machine settings and create a reproducible foam process, only a few parameters have been changed during our design of experiment, to ensure similar conditions and to evaluate the foamability of different formulations. Amorphous polyalpha olefins are very suitable for the foaming application. The amorphous parts are important for good adhesion to various substrates, and the crystalline parts give high bonding strengths and influence the setting and open time. But the combination of amorphous and crystalline parts is also important for the foaming process. To create a smooth foam structure, the backbone polymer has the highest influence. To allow the gas to solve in the polymer, it must be flexible enough to allow the gas to disperse between the molecular chains. After releasing it from the applicator, the bubbles expand, and the polymer needs to be flexible enough to allow the volume expansion, while at the same time having enough resetting force to keep the gas inside, to avoid the agglomeration and the transfer to the surface until the setting time is reached. The right balance between amorphous and crystalline parts, adhesion and flexibility combined with the cohesion is the key for a good foamable polymer, as well as to keep the bubbles in a finely dispersed size inside the hot melt formulation to avoid degassing. Amorphous polyalpha olefins combine these properties due to the very broad molecular weight distribution, also the rheological behavior of the formulation and the viscosity will influence the bubble size, the open and setting time, as we will see in the course of this presentation. The investigation is based on two common Vestoplast grades, Vestoplast 703 with a high softening point of 124 degrees Celsius and a low viscosity of 3000 millipascal at 190 degrees, and the harder, more crystalline Vestoplast 408 with a viscosity of 8000 millipascal at 190 degrees Celsius. The polymer was tested purely in the first step to see the performance. The polymer often is the main part of a hot melt formulation and therefore gives the key properties. With our test procedure, we could reach a maximum foaming rate up to 70% nitrogen or air content. To evaluate the change of the polymer, we took microscope pictures of different foaming ratios of Estoplast 703. Starting with the negative test, the nitrogen content was increased step by step. The bubble size remained similar. Fine distributed bubbles bedded in the polymer structure. Even with very high nitrogen content, the bubbles are small and covered with a fine polymer shell without any agglomeration until the setting time of the polymer is reached. The evaluation phase was started based on the design of experiment, keeping many settings stable to create better comparable results. The nitrogen pre-pressure was increased step by step, as you can see on the x-axis. The weight measure is recorded at the y-axis. Therefore, the volume was kept stable. With increasing nitrogen amount, the weight of the foam mixture decreased dramatically at 150 and 130 degrees Celsius. A density reduction of the mixture could be detected. Vestoplast 703 starts to take in the nitrogen already at a very early stage, starting at around 40% nitrogen content and thereby reducing the polymer content down to 60%. The trend continues until it reaches the peak at 70% nitrogen and 30% polymer content. This is the maximum amount of gas that you can add to this system, maintaining a good foaming appearance. If you decrease the application temperature, the foaming is shifted to a later stage due to higher viscosity in the beginning. There are slight differences between the two polymers, which had been chosen exemplary for a comparison between all the different Vestoplast grades, based on the temperature and viscosity changes. You can choose the Vestoplast type which fits best to your needs without any huge changes in the foaming behavior. To show the effect of different polymer backbones on foaming properties, we have tested those within the same viscosity range as our chosen Vestoplast grades. Surprisingly, the maximum gas content value that could be reached with all the alternative polymers was much lower compared to the Vestoplast grades. This can be explained by the different polymer structures. Some polymers exhibit enough cohesion to keep the nitrogen inside the polymer matrix after the release at the applicator, but they are not flexible enough to allow the nitrogen to mix properly with the matrix and to disperse homogeneously between the polymer chains. So far, we have shown you the effect of foamed pure polymers and the influence of different polymer backbones on their foaming properties. However, to fulfill the physical requirements for thousands of different applications, Vestoplast is mostly used combined with several additives or other Vestoplast grades and formulations. As each application is unique, it is often requires unique compositions. To investigate the effect of formulation additives, we also tested different formulations containing different resins, oils, and Vestoplast combinations. It could be observed that the impact of oil is on the foaming properties quite significant. The oil itself had no cohesion or adhesion properties, and it is mainly served as viscosity modifier. Therefore, the foamability of the formulation is reduced and lower gas amount can be incorporated and the bubble size is bigger. Resins are very crystalline molecules and increase adhesion. There is a lack of flexibility due to their low molecular weight. Therefore, they limit the capability of gas absorption. To support our findings in the experiments, we have also taken microscope pictures of the described foamed formulations. All chosen formulations could be foamed, but to a different extent, and particularly the bubble size of the incorporated gas varies a lot. In formulations with oil, the bubble size is much bigger, confirmed the lack of cohesion to prevent the gas from expanding. In formulations with resin, the crystalline structure can still be detected between the bubbles, preventing a full homogeneous dispersion of the gas between the polymer matrix. Therefore, it is so important to fine-tune your formulation and add the additives in small steps to reach the required physical parameters while maintaining the forming ratio on a high level. This effect can also be seen in our design of experiment, where we also investigated an optimized formulation, including several additives. By balancing the properties of formulation additives with the polymer backbone, very good forming results can be achieved. In this example, the formulation can be formed up to the same maximum level as the pure polymer material. The key is to formulate carefully, to maintain the crystalline and amorphous properties in order to achieve excellent forming results and secure a broad application window. After all, the maximum forming ratio is not always the key parameter for good adhesives, because the main focus are the adhesion properties. For sure, with higher forming values and higher nitrogen content, the impact of the bonding properties will increase as well. But a high forming value also indicates a wide application window for a system that is more robust to parameter changes and machine settings. As I mentioned before, the foaming technology is not new. In the filter market, it is well known and used for several years. The adhesive consumption can be reduced and the applied adhesive is much more flexible due to the foam structure. In addition, the foamed adhesive can be a benefit for irregular substrates, like in a filter. The adhesive will not sink into the filter pleats, it will lay on the top and fixate the pleats. Besides the filter application, there are more substrates which can be a huge benefit, for example, the mattress bonding application. APRO-based foamed adhesives add a lot of flexibility to your process. If manual or automatic application, due to the high flexibility of the raw material, the important parameters like viscosity and open time can be easily adjusted. Another interesting application area without the need for special adhesion properties is a gap-filling application used in the white goods industry. The amount of hot melt can be reduced significantly while maintaining good sealing properties and an excellent optical impression, as these are crucial for this field of application. We have now almost reached the end of this web seminar, and it leads us to the question, why is foaming for adhesives so interesting for the industry? First, it is resource efficient. You can save adhesive depending on your adhesion requirements. Second, depending on the area of application, the adhesive properties can be improved. The bonding will be more flexible, the open time longer, and you have a very good adhesion, especially to very porous and irregular substrates. The adhesive will not penetrate fully into your substrate, much more it will lay on the top until the second substrate will be counter-laminated. Vestoplast-based formulations can achieve very high forming rates, a huge application window for easier processing in various machine settings. The good optical impression and low odor ratio makes Vestoplast even more interesting for end customer or high quality applications. After all, the formulation and the foaming ratio needs to be adjusted to every special requirement, depending on the end application. This example shows that specialty chemicals, and that's where we are among the best in class. This is our self-conception, leading beyond chemistry to improve life today and tomorrow. This is how we are setting new standards in the chemical industry and beyond. For further questions to this application or our products in general, we would be happy to get in contact with you and find the best solution for your problems.